And there's big breaking news coming in. The death penalty has been granted to all the three accused in the Delhi rape case. Remember, that took place 2 years ago. The woman was 19 years old when she was abducted, gang raped, had acid thrown and poured on her eyes to blind her, hot iron rods to brand her. She bled to death for 3 long days before her body was finally found. The Dwarka court, remember, had called this the rarest of rare cases, and the quantum of punishment was all set to be announced today. And we're getting you the breaking news right now. The death penalty has in fact been awarded to all these three accused in the rape case. Remember, this rape took place in February in 2012. And we have our reporter joining us on the phone line with more details. Over to you.
Initial details coming in. It barely took 30 seconds. The judge said the death sentence has been awarded. There's only one provision of law under which they were convicted, which has a facility for a death sentence or a provision for death sentence. That is 302. But combined with the fact that this is a depraved act of gang rape and mutilation and destruction of evidence, this has been considered a rarest of rare case. And all three, Rahul, Vinod and Ravi, and Ravi being brothers, they've all been given the death sentence by the Dwarka court. Of course, under Section 366 of the CRPC, this will have to be confirmed by the High Court eventually.
Right.
But for now, from this trial court, they have been awarded the death sentence.
Right, just Kira, the Dwarka court awarding the death sentence. If you can, as you mentioned to us, that this took all of 30 seconds in court, but if you can actually just give us details of what was said in court before this death sentence was awarded to these three accused in this rape case.
Well, the arguments for the sentencing after the conviction was confirmed took place earlier this week, where the defense suggested that there is a chance for these youngsters, because their ages are 23, 23 and 27, so there's a chance for them to go forward and actually reform themselves. However, the Delhi police sought the maximum punishment of death penalty, saying that this was the rarest of rare crime. And it was a very brutal, depraved act of not just rape, but also murder in the worst sense, where the victim didn't just die completely suddenly, but was actually bled to death over a few days.
Just Kira, thank you for bringing us that update. Stay with us. Let's just cut across to Preeti Chaudhary, who also has in fact been giving us updates throughout the day. She was joining us from outside the Dwarka court. Preeti, death penalty granted to all three accused in this brutal gang rape case that took place 2 years ago. You are with the parents of the victim. What is the sense you're getting right now?
Sanjana, the parents are still inside the court. The sentence was announced just about 5 minutes ago. What we do know, body language-wise, and understandably so. Both Kuwar Singh Negi, the father of Kiran, broke down, hugged his wife. It's been a long battle for them, Sanjana. To give you a perspective, they've had absolutely no financial aid. He's a class 4 employee, the father of Kiran. He subsists on a salary of 5,000 rupees. He's got two kids to take care of, but he did not let go. He was fighting till the end. I'm going to get in Jaskirat. Jaskirat, who's just come in court, is going to give us details. Jaskirat, can you tell our viewers exactly what transpired?
Well, what exactly happened in the court today? It took all of 30 seconds, as we mentioned a while before. Most of the arguments have already taken place earlier this week. Now, the reaction, sudden reaction of the family members was that of exhilaration. There was joy. There was also the maternal aunt of the girl, the victim over here. She actually fainted for a while over there. She was having some breathing issues because this was a very overwhelming situation for the family members.
You know, stay on with us. Jaskirat Singh trying to go and get the father for us at this point of time. The father and the mother have both broken down. As Jaskirat was pointing out, the mother especially, she's an asthmatic patient. The minute the sentencing was announced, she just sat down and she had trouble breathing. Understandably, very high on emotions, even outside court. You know, there have been people. I'll just ask my camera person to Prabir, to actually give you a sense of what's going on at this point of time. Now, there's been a massive stakeout of people who have been protesting over the last 2 years on how slow this case was going on. Giving our viewers perspective, Nirbhaya happened 9 months after Kiran, and heard the sentencing last year itself. So it has been a long battle, but finally justice delivered. Death to all three perpetrators, the murderers and rapists of young Kiran Negi. Would like to cut across. We're getting reactions at this point of time. Ranjana Kumari, Abha Singh, both on the phone line with us. Ranjana, first quick comment. 2 years is a long time await for justice.
Hello?
Ranjana, can you hear me? Ranjana, can you hear me? All right, we seem to be having a problem trying to connect to Ranjana Kumari. I'd like to cut across to Abha Singh, senior noted lawyer. She joins us from Mumbai at this point of time. Abha, a long battle of 2 years, finally death sentence to all three. Quick comments. All right, we're going to try and connect to both Abha and Ranjana. Would like to just give our viewers perspective on what exactly transpired in the Dwarka court just about 10 minutes ago. Death sentence to all three convicted. Now all three of them have been given the death sentence. We do know that just minutes after the death sentence was announced, both the father and the mother broke down. The mother is an asthmatic patient. She's been having trouble breathing. She was administered first aid, but been a long fight. The father had absolutely no financial help. The parents, in fact, have just come out. We're going to try and get them live. He spoke to us today morning and he said very clearly that don't call her Nirbhaya, don't call her by any other name. Her name was Kiran Negi. She did absolutely nothing wrong. She was coming from work at about 8:30 at night and she was abducted, brutally raped and killed. All right, let's try and cut across back to Ranjana Kumari and Abha Singh, who's on the phone line with us. Abha, if you can hear me, quick comments. Death sentence after 2 years. All right, we're going to try and reconnect and get our viewers the very latest reactions on that. But just hear you. Well, these are the visuals right outside Dwarka court at this point of time. Scenes of jubilation, understandably so. There are many people out here right behind me who've been campaigning relentlessly for the last 2 years and hoping to get justice, finally justice delivered. For many of our viewers, they don't know who Kiran Negi is. Well, she was a 19-year-old girl. If the nation's conscience was shook by what happened to Nirbhaya, well, 9 months before. Nirbhaya case happened in December 2012. In February 2012, there was the case of young Kiran Negi. A 19-year-old girl was abducted right outside her house when she was returning home. She was brutally gang-raped by three men. Her body was mutilated. There was acid poured all over her. Unlike Nirbhaya, who bravely fought in a hospital bed, this young girl for 3 days, and that is what the autopsy report showed, for 3 days bled slowly to death before life ebbed away in a mustard field in Rewari, Haryana. Ranjana Singh is back with us, I believe, on the phone line at this point of time. Ranjana, quick comments. Finally, justice delivered for Kiran.
First of all, I'm Ranjana Kumari. I think it's very, very important that such judgments come, and this kind of a strong statement from the court will be the only way which will deter people who are thinking that they can get away with all kinds of real cruel and you know, this kind right. of a crime and can get away with that. I'm very happy that finally we hear Kiran Negi getting the justice even after her death. I think this is totally you know, a good judgment. I agree with that. I know
Ranjana.
Ranjana,
it was a case which was completely forgotten by the media. You also know that. You know, this all happened before Nirbhaya. You know, if Kiran's case was taken over, the father says maybe Nirbhaya would have never happened.
Yeah, that is what we have been experiencing. And as you know, we run Rape Crisis Intervention Center. We remember each and every case that has happened in Delhi. So we haven't forgotten Kiran's case, neither Nirbhaya's case. But absolutely right, Kiran's father is that if such cases are dealt with real firm hands, and also the law of the land really acts as swiftly as possible through fast track, then more cases will not come to light, and there will be some stop at the heinous crime that we have all been witnessing in past few years, in all these gang rapes where girls have been targeted, they have been mutilated, their bodies have been mutilated, they have been killed. This heinous crime could stop if such judgments can come and such cases can get attention of everybody and also can be brought to justice quickly.
You know, appreciate you. Do stay on with us, Ranjana, because we want to come back to you. There's Abha Singh, noted lawyer and activist from Mumbai, who's on the phone line with us at this point of time. Abha, the question I'd like to put across is, Kiran's father, Kumar Singh, has been fighting for 2 years. He has absolutely no fiscal bandwidth to take this case forward. He's put every bit of rupee of his savings to see his child get justice. The question I ask you is, what happens to the Nirbhaya fund? This year, when we heard the finance minister say that he's adding more to it, the fund is sitting pretty. People like Kumar Singh, people like Kiran, who need the money to get justice, have absolutely nothing.
Yeah, I agree with you. Even the 100 crore which was set aside last year for Nirbhaya fund, not a penny was used out of it. So definitely people like Kiran's father should be the ones who should be given. The whole legal battle should be paid by the government, because legal fees is very high. People have to sell their land and property to get justice in the court. And now when we are so serious about offense against women, I think this Nirbhaya fund should be. But the problem is that the government, you know how the file moves, and a person may apply and it may take years. So I think the police prosecutors or the court itself, the fast track courts which are handling women cases, they should have the funds at their disposal where the judges himself can, while giving a judgment, can pay the whole cost of the legal thing. And also, as I was discussing with your channel in the morning, death penalty was required, because the message had to go that we are serious about it, and rightly so. Had you were saying that had this case been decided earlier, I'm sure Nirbhaya would not have happened.
All right, stay on with us, Abha. Reactions coming in at this point of time. What we do know, somebody has just told us that Kiran's mother has actually fainted inside the court's premises. Understandably so, emotions are running high at this point of time. Today morning, we had spoken to Kuwar Singh Negi, the father of Kiran, and he came across, and the first thing he told us was, I was standing and talking to him, and he told me, don't call her 19-year-old, don't call her Nirbhaya, don't call her anything else. Her name was Kiran Negi. He also, I want to tell our viewers, before he went inside the court's premises, he's been coming here for 2 years every day. He's had at least 35 dates that he has attended on this particular case. He came, he hung Kiran's picture on the gate of the Dwarka court. He's taken it, somebody's taken it out at this point of time. And he said, whoever comes here has to see the picture of my girl. She was 19-year-old and it was absolutely no fault of hers. Why shouldn't I show what she looked like, what her name was, what her identity was? We're going to cut across back to Ranjana Singh at this point of time. You know, Ranjana, many a times the brutality that a rape victim faces never really comes to the fore. Something that Kiran faced, you know, even if you compare Ranjana to the brutalities of Nirbhaya, they were far worse. There was acid poured in her eyes. Her body was mutilated. Her face was mutilated for 3 years. The autopsy report says this young girl, Kiran Negi, just bled till life ebbed away from her body.
And this was cruel, this was criminal, what was done to Kiran. But at the same time, I must tell you, the government has been very irresponsible, very insensitive in not spending the 1,000 crores. It's not 100 crores, it is 1,000 crores. And now putting another 1,000 crores to say, okay, fine, this is non-lapsable and this will be spent. I don't know when and who and what. Because there is no scheme, there is no program, there is no vision how they can support victims, their livelihood,
right.
Question of their contesting the cases in the court. All those things will have to be covered. The government has to be responsible. Unfortunately, the money was not spent, and this is the most, you know, irresponsible behavior of any government anywhere. When you look at the way government of India has treated this fund and not helped people like Kiran's parents and, you know, to meet out the expenses at the court. At the same time, I want to say one more thing, that, you know, it is extremely important that such cases are really, really talked about, and, you know, through media, through all of us, should go across to the country that, you know, you cannot get away with this. You will be punished, and punishment is as severe as what in the case of Kiran Negi has been given.
All right, Ranjana Kumari, stay on with us. Abha Singh is also with us at this point of time. Abha, that's what we were talking about in terms of funds, in terms of the Nirbhaya fund. How is it actually getting channelized when people here need it most? Case in example, Kumar Singh Negi, the father of young Kiran. All right, we seem to have lost Abha Singh at this point of time, but let's get in reactions from people who've been here for the last 2 years. कैसा आप दो साल से यहाँ पर आए जा रहे हैं किरण के सपोर्ट में, दो साल के बाद सजाए मौत दी गई है, थोड़ा भरोसा अभी आया है जुडिशरी पर?
हमें बहुत खुशी मिली है, हमें वीरेंद्र भट्ट के शुक्रगुजार हैं, उन्होंने हमारे को न्याय दिलाया। हम दो साल से यहाँ पैर घिस गए थे, आज हमें सब भूल गए हैं। हमको इतनी खुशी है, इतनी खुशी है, ऐसी हर लड़की को न्याय मिलना चाहिए जैसे आज इसको मिला है।
Let's try and get more reactions at this point of time. Now they've been campaigning steadfastly. बहुत बहुत पहले से आप लड़ रही हैं, पिछले दो साल से यहाँ पर आ रही हैं किरण के लिए। आपको लगता है कि अगर किरण का मुद्दा निर्भया जैसे उठाया होता तो हो सकता था कि निर्भया का केस ही नहीं होता?
बिल्कुल, बिल्कुल। अगर जैसे ये आज मीडिया में ये केस आया है किरण नेगी का, अगर ये पहले किरण नेगी का केस आया होता तो निर्भया का केस मैं कहती होता ही नहीं। उतनी फिर और फोर्स लगती और इतनी अवेयरनेस फैलती लोगों में। जैसे आज एकजुट होकर लोग आए, ऐसे सड़कों में और भी लोग आते और ज्यादा लोग वो करते तो निर्भया का केस तो होता ही नहीं।
क्या कहना चाहेंगे आप? उनके फादर और उनके मदर से काफी क्लोज रहे हैं, उनसे आपकी लगातार बातचीत होती रही है। मदर ब्रेकडाउन हो गई है, फेंट हो गई थी कोर्ट में, फादर के जो टेयर्स हैं वो नहीं रुक पाए। तो
बीच में उन्हें ऐसा लगता था कि कहीं हमें न्याय मिले या ना मिले, लेकिन आज उनको इतना सुकून मिला है कि उनकी बेटी की आत्मा को जो शांति मिली होगी, आज हम सबकी जो एकता की एकता ने दिखाया कि उनकी बेटी के लिए जो न्याय लड़े, वो उन सभी का हम धन्यवाद करते हैं। और उनकी आज जो सबकी आत्मा को भी पूरा सुकून मिला कि हाँ हमें न्याय मिला है, और वीरेंद्र भट्ट जी ने एक सही पोल न्याय किया, और उन जो वकील साहब थी उन्होंने भी पूरी केस को एकदम बिल्कुल हैंडल किया और आज हमें न्याय मिला, उसके लिए बहुत बहुत।
और हमें तो यहाँ से न्याय मिला है और हम आगे भी चाहते हैं कि आगे भी अगर ये केस डालते हैं लड़के लोग मुजरिम, आगे भी केस डालेंगे हाईकोर्ट में, तो वहाँ से इनकी अर्जी हम
हाईकोर्ट भी जाएंगे। हम हमारे साथ ये सही वो नहीं हुआ, इंसाफ नहीं हुआ, हम हाईकोर्ट तक जाएंगे, इसका इंसाफ लेके रहेंगे। और इस लड़की को बहुत अच्छा वो मिला, जो जितने भी हमारी लेडी।
Alright, we want to tell our viewers, most people here come from the locality where Kiran Negi was living in. She used to live in Dwarka at Kutub Vihar, that is where she was abducted 2 years earlier. These very people had staged a dharna outside the Chawala police station in Kutub Vihar when they were not taking enough action. Some of them steadfastly have been fighting for 2 years right from the police station there and to the court's premises. Over 35 sittings have happened, 35 sessions have happened, and they have come here each and every time. Ranjana Kumari, I believe, is still with us at this point of time on the phone line. Ranjana, somewhere down the line, we need to salute this quantum of sentence which has come, because when Nirbhaya got death, many people thought that was a case in isolation. Ranjana Kumari, can you hear me? All right, we seem to have lost Ranjana at this point of time, but give our viewers perspective. Let's just, I'll ask Prabir, my camera person, to give you a pan shot of what's going on outside the Dwarka court, very reminiscent of what had happened during the times of Nirbhaya, because we've all reported on it. Nobody expected this kind of emotion here, because this case was forgotten in judicial files. You know, you can see that people are cheering there. There are shots of jubilation. Most of them have come from the locality of Kiran. I have one such person. Yeah. So, 2 years back, you were one of the few people who sat outside the Chawala police station when they did not take action. Life's come full circle. Somewhere down the line, do you feel there's no closure, of course, but justice?
Yeah, yeah. You know, see, we call justice delayed, but you know, we can say it was delayed for 2 years, but it has not been denied. You know, we have got what we wanted, and we wanted that sentence for all these three people, and that has been fulfilled. So we are happy for the movement. But the insistence delay which had happened, you know, that is a cause of concern, because every time you have to hit, you have to come on the road for asking your justice. That should be a natural process.
Did you feel let down? Did you feel let down because the country came together for Nirbhaya? Kiran somewhere was forgotten.
Yeah, 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 yeah. you know, I completely agree with, you know, what you're saying, because every time, you know, why, you know, Nirbhaya was just a case in isolation actually, and after this was, this had happened much before, than 9 months before Nirbhaya had happened, and we have to come on the road and fight this battle. You know, that is what, that is, you know, the legal action should happen automatically. There should be natural justice to each citizen of India. Why everyone has to come on the road and ask for the justice? You know, that is the cause of concern for all of us actually.
Mata ji, bahut lambi ladai rahi hai.
Beta, bahut acha kara Bhagwan ne. Aise jeet hoye Bhagwan kare toh. Aise jeet hoye.
Zindabad. Lot of people who've come here at this point of time. I can't actually hear the studio from the din of all of this, but want to tell our viewers, very soon we'd be joined by the father of Kiran. He is attending to his wife at this point of time. She had fainted on the court's premises. The father had broken down. There were tears which flowed inside 605 courtroom right behind me at Dwarka Court. But all three of the convicts have now been awarded the death sentence, something which people here have been fighting very, very long for. 2 years is a long time for that. So once again, a little bit of a perspective. People have come here from not just the locality. There are lots of NGOs who are attached to this. People want to say something. Boliye, kya bolna chahte?
The government has released the 1,000 crore rupees fund for the Nirbhaya case. But the government must have issued the hard decisions on these matters. Then the ladies of the affected people of this whole will get justice.
Point made. An interesting point that we've been talking about earlier on the issue of the Nirbhaya fund. There are people like Kumar Singh Negi, justice for Kiran, which needed that kind of money and they never got it. And there are many, many other battles like Kiran which are being fought across the country at this point of time. And that is where the money needs to go to and not just keep being added into the kitty which is called the Nirbhaya Fund and never utilized. We'll keep getting our viewers the very latest. We're going to try and get more reactions. I believe we've lost Ranjana Kumari and Abba Singh. We're going to try and cut across to them as well. But you know, people want to come and say something. Since the time we've been here, every 5 minutes I've been here, they've constantly come and they say, we want to talk, you know, we want to put a point across. What do you want to say?
मैडम किरण नेगी को न्याय मिले और हम बहुत खुश हैं. हमारा पूरा उत्तराखंड समाज बहुत ज़्यादा खुश है. इतने दिनों से यहाँ आ रहे हैं और एक एक आदमी को हम यहाँ पे वो बुला रहे हैं मीडिया के माध्यम से, फेसबुक के माध्यम से. हमारी बहुत बड़ी मुहिम है और इसमें विनोद बच्छेदी, गोकुल नेगी, बहन सजवान, हम सब लोग इकट्ठे हो गए. हमारा जो आज कॉज था वो पूरा हुआ है और हम बहुत खुश हैं. किरण नेगी अमर रहे, किरण नेगी अमर रहे. बस ये
जो समाज के अंदर मानव की खाल में छुपे दानव हैं, उन तक ये मैसेज जाना चाहिए कि आगे ऐसा दुराचार ना करें, इस तरह की हिम्मत ना दिखाएं.
An example needs to be made. That's what this gentleman is trying to say. Many had thought what we were talking about earlier, that when we had seen the quantum of sentence being announced for Nirbhaya, maybe it was a case in isolation because the case had got so much national coverage. It was a protest which turned into a movement at that point of time. So there was a bit of a fear of that. And today many people who'd come asking for justice for Kiran feared that maybe the three perpetrators of the most heinous crime could get away with just life. Well, that's not happened. So that's a huge breather for many people out here. But once again, let's cut across and get our viewers a little more reactions that we are getting in at this point of time. To tell our viewers on the case of Kiran Negi, not many people know of Kiran Negi, while the imprint of Nirbhaya is in every heart of India. But in February 2012, 9 months before the Nirbhaya incident took place, a young girl, she was all of 19, had gone to Cyber City to work. She came back at 8:30 p.m. with three of her friends from the same office. She was walking to work at Kutub Vihar in Dwarka. She was dragged in and gang raped, murdered, mutilated. For 3 days she lay in a field while she slowly bled to death. Constant coverage on that story right from Dwarka Court. We hopefully would be joined by the father of Kiran Negi.